What is up, guys? Welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman. Let me show you what we're making today. Here's this guy and he can jump, just a regular platform object. But if I have control, I can slow down time. Watch this. Right, so that's coming up next in the Sparckman channel. Alright guys, before we continue, smack the like button and subscribe if you're not subscribed. So let's open Construct 3. Let's go to construct.net. Now you don't have to install Construct 3. All you have to do is go to construct.net and you can start using Construct. Yeah, there is no installation required, so you can just start using Construct. So let's create a new project. I'm going to make this a letterbox. So let's call this a super slow. Oops. Optimize for pixel art. There we go. Now this canvas here is a little too big. Let me just make this smaller. Like 40 by 480. That looks better. So let's right click and let's insert a new sprite. It's my sprite. So let me make this purple. Actually, this might be a little too big. Let me just make this smaller. Make it 90 by 90. So let's close this. There is. I'm going to insert another sprite. Just because we can. Let's make this green. Here we go. This is going to be the ground. Now the graphics are terrible, but you can make better graphics. This is just an example. So I'm going to grab another sprite. And I'm going to make it smaller. So let's make our object a platform object. Add a behavior. Scroll down to platformer. Close that. I'm going to make the ground a solid object. And let's run this. Let me maximize this. Click on the stage. View, and let's set the full screen mode to scale outer. Try it out, and that works already. So now we want to slow down time. This is going to be super simple. So let's add a progress bar. Place it right here. Let me set the value to 1 and the maximum to 1 as well. See what that looks like. There is our progress bar. We're also going to need a keyboard object, so we can use the keyboard. There it is. You can't actually see it, but it's here. Let's go to events, add a new event, and let me see. Let's compare this to our timer. If the time is greater than 1. Then we're going to set our time scale, set object time scale, select the object, and we're going to set it equals our progress bar value of progress bar. Now if you run this, you're going to notice that nothing happens. Whoa, what's going on? So let's add a new event, keyboard event. If a key is down, choose the key. Let's try control. So if control is down, we are going to subtract from our progress bar. Set progress equals the current progress. Minus 0.1. Press control. And that works not too bad. It's a little too fast. Let's try 0.0 0.02. Try it again. And that's much better. Let me just copy this and paste it. So now we have three actions. So let's invert this. So now it's if control is not being pressed. So we set the progress to plus 0.02. Try it out. Jump. Hold control. And it kind of works, except for it actually stops. So let's add another action here. Another condition, I meant to say. So this is only going to work if our progress is greater than 0.2. Try it out. Jump. Okay, kind of works. I think it should go back up faster. Maybe 4. You can use a multiplier too, and it probably will look better. Maybe set the progress greater than 1. See what that looks like. I think it should still go back up a bit faster. Try 9. Yeah, I think that looks a lot better now. Jump. Okay, jump. And that's much better. You can slow down just about anything with this. So now you could add a slowdown sound, but for now this looks near too bad. Maybe we can do that in the next video. Alright guys, so that's it. You can play around with this. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to smack the like button. Bye now.